Hi everyone and welcome to this new Twinmotion tutorial. In today's video, we want to focus on all things materials. You can find the material in the library in the Materials folder. Here it's divided in many different subcategories. You can open any folder and find all the material you need here. If you want to see more material at once, you can just expand the library by dragging the edge like that. Here, I want to start work on the parking lot in front of our project here. That project is supposed to be in a natural environment, so I want to stick with natural materials. So here, I'm going to come to the ground and enter the nature folder. If you want to drag and drop a material on your project, it's pretty simple. You can just drag and drop the material from the library onto the geometry you want to add it to. As you can see, there are various types of materials, from snow, to sand, to pebbles, to dirt, to grass. Once you have added the material to your project, on the right of the screen you have all the properties. For that video, I won't need the scene organizer that we can see at the top of the screen. So I'm going to click on Scene to hide it, so we can see more of the options we have on materials. First thing I would like to do here is to change a bit the scale of that material because it seems a bit off right now. So we'll come to the UV section and just lower the scale. As we can see here on the right, we have many options. Some of them are open by default because those are the most used and the most important option. So here we retrieve the rotation of the UV, the scale, the roughness, the metallic. You can also close all those options if you want by clicking on their name. So here we have a better understanding of all the options and the different categories they are sorted in. So here I'm just going to add some gravel to our parking lot. I'm going again to change the UV to have something a bit smaller, like that. So now let's look at all the options available. I'm going to start with color. In the color, you can first, change the color here with that icon. It opens that color wheel and here you can give, change, customize a bit the color of the material you have selected. Here you can add some grunge. The grunge is a layer of dirt that adds on top of your material just to break up the repetition of it. It's all the small dark area that you can see over here. For natural material, it adds a nice little detail and again, from a distance, it breaks up that repetition that we may see. Here we can change the luminosity, making your material darker or lighter. And in the detail, we have the option first to load the texture and then to customize that texture. For example, here you can change the saturation of your texture. And here you have access to the gamma, the lift, the gain, and you can go even beyond that by expanding each option and change the RGB value of the gamma or the lift or the gain. So you can go really in depth in some of the material customization inside Twinmotion. The next option we have is the UV. So we already saw the scale, so you can make your material bigger or smaller. You can also change the rotation. So that won't work really well on that seamless gravel material. To better see that, I'm going to use a man-made, something like those concrete tiles here. So here, as you can see, I can just use the rotation slider to turn my material the way I want. In the detail section, you will find option to stretch your texture over a specific axis. So for example, here, my rectangular slab, I could make them square. I can change the offset if I want to move my texture in a specific direction, or I can even animate that. Obviously, it doesn't work really well with some concrete slab on a parking lot, but you can use that, for example, on a glowing billboard against the wall. Next, we have the roughness. The roughness here controls how reflective your material is. So here, as you can see, you have a bit of reflection on that ground surface, that concrete slab. You can raise or lower the roughness by playing with that slider. At 0%, your material will be completely reflective, almost like a mirror, On the opposite side, at 100%, your material is completely rough, meaning no reflection at all. At 50%, it uses the exact texture that is loaded in the detail panel. So here, as you can see, you have that grunge texture that is loaded in that concrete material. And again, at 50%, it uses exactly that texture. There is also an option to invert that texture. Both the roughness and the metallic map use a grayscale texture. And on both, you have that invert texture that allows you to switch the white to black and the black to white. Next, as I said, we have the metallic. The metallic controls how metallic your material is. In a physically based rendering, also known as PBR workflow, a material is either metallic or it's non-metallic. That means you usually are at 0 or at 100%. To give more creativity to our creators, we left that slider allowing to fine-tune your specific materials. And again, in the details, you can load the texture and invert it. Next, we have the normal. To show you that, I'm just going to switch to another material that I quite like. It's in the nature and it's those pebbles. Let's come a bit closer, and here we can see two different effects. The first effect we can see is the normal map, but we have also the parallax. So let's disable first the parallax and focus first only on the normal map. Here, when I'm playing with that slider while the parallax map is disabled, I'm only touching the normal map and playing with its intensity. There is also an option to invert that normal map, the green channel of the texture. If I'm turning on the parallax, it uses the height map that is loaded in that channel. The height map defines what is the highest and the lowest value, and it creates some depth inside your material. And it really doesn't create any geometry. Here, in the slider, you can also control its intensity and where is the reference plane of the texture that is used. Next, we have the emissive. The emissive controls if your material is emitting light or not. We are going to see that in another material a bit later, but the basic here is that when you start to raise that slider, it will start to emit light. On the mask here, you can load the texture. It's especially useful if you have, for example, a logo with no background, if you have also some foliage. Here, on some pebbles, it won't really work, but it's an option that is available. If you are loading a PNG with no background, TwinMotion automatically recognizes that, and the Use Mask option will allow you to see through that material. But if you have an opacity texture in addition to your diffuse texture, you can click here and you can load your opacity map. Next option is the X-ray option. To show you that, I will create a small geometry. I will come to my library, Object, Primitive. I'm going to drop that cylinder here. Just going to change a bit the scale. And here, what I want to do is actually fake some kind of pipe going underneath my project. I'm going to move that pipe underneath my floor. And actually, I'm going to come a bit lower to my ground to actually see my pipe again. In TwinMotion, if you want to select a material, you can go at the bottom of the screen, open this. Here you will find all the material inside your scene. But what I want to do here is use the material picker at the top of the screen. When you click on that icon, now you can click anywhere inside your project and it will show the material to click on. So for example, here, that's the material of my pipe. So now that this material is selected, I can come again above my ground. I will come to my X-ray option. I will turn this option on. This allows me, as you can see here, to see an object through everything. That's very convenient if you want to see your piping, your plumbing, or your vents through your walls. You can even customize the color, the opacity, or the falloff. Finally, in the mask option, you can enable the two-sided option. For example, here, if I'm coming underneath my parking lot, we can see that we can see the sky. If I select again my pebbles, come a bit underneath it, I will select the two-sided, and here we can now see the pebbles from underneath. The next option is the weather, whether or not your material is affected by the weather. So for example, let's open back the scene, ambience. I will make it rain whilst playing with that slider. And by default, all the material are affected by the weather, as we can see here. But sometimes you may not want that material to be affected. So what you can do here is select the material picker, click on the pebbles, come to the misc and disable the weather effect. This way, that specific material won't be affected anymore by the weather effect. Finally, at the bottom, we have the sound, because indeed, when you press M inside TwinMotion, you are actually walking on the ground at the height of a human being, and you make sound based on the type of material you are walking on. So here I'm walking on a concrete type of material, but I can switch from a carpet, a ground, or all the different types that are visible here. So let's disable the rain, coming back to ambience, removing the rain so we can fully appreciate our scene here. I'm going to come back to my library, materials, ground, nature. I'm going to come back with my gravel with just a smaller scale and with also a bit of grunge. All the options that you can see here are the options present on the base material inside TwinMotion. But there are actually many different types of material inside TwinMotion, and all those types of material come with different options. So for example, here, if I come back to the root of my material folder, let's come a bit closer to our car here. I will come to the glass, and I'm going to drag and drop that glass material. As you can see here, on the right, we have completely different options. Like here, we can change the opacity. We can still change the color, which is the same on every material. But here, we have also access to the Fresnel and some other options like the colored shadows. Next, another example here will be with the car paint. So here, if I'm coming to that side of my car, I'm going to the materials folder. Towards the bottom, we have the car paint. Here, I'm just going to drag and drop, for example, that blue car paint material. Once I've added that material, so we can come a bit closer, we can see the orange peel effect on the side of the car over here. And here on the right, we have options related to that type of material. So for example, here we can turn on the flakes. So here we can see the flakes in the car paint. In addition to that, we can also customize the color of the flakes and go really in all the details of that car paint material. We can even turn on the chameleon effect here. Earlier, I was talking about the emissive material. This is an example where the emissive material option will be useful. So for example, here, let's close all the tabs and open the emissive option. Here, as you can see, I've set the maximum value. And I actually even go beyond that value. So right now, when you move a slider, there is a min and a max value. So right now, the max value of the glow option is 100 nits. If you want to go further than the max value, you can simply click on the box here and type manually the value you want. So here, for example, I want to type 800, so we can increase the maximum value of the slider manually this way. So right now, to make those real light glow, I've been using a standard material to do that, and I would just raise the emissive and set the luminance filter to red. What you can also do is use, at the bottom of the library, a neon type of material. Those materials have some different options than the regular TwinMotion material. So here I will drag and drop the neon material on this part of the car, and we can see that the options are a bit different. So here, for example, the color, I'm just going to turn it red. Same idea here, I can tweak the intensity of that glowing material. Using some of those materials, we can even have some animation. It won't work well, obviously, on that piece of the car, but just to give you the idea that here, if I raise again the intensity, we can have that material that is blinking. We can even change the speed by coming in the UV section and here changing the speed on the Y-axis. You can also use a texture to create that glow effect. So for example, here I selected the material on the screen inside my car. What I'm going to do here is open the detail of the color. I will click on my diffuse texture. I'm going to copy that texture. That texture was actually applied in 3ds Max in my CAD software, and when I imported my car, automatically the texture was retrieved during the import process. Now what I want to do is apply that texture in the emissive channel. So I'm going to expand the emissive option, open details, and here I'm going to simply paste my texture. Now that my texture has been loaded, what I can do is here raise the glow. And as you can see, it will start to glow based on the texture I've loaded. So the white part will be more glowing than the dark part. Let's now have a look at some of the options in the toolbar related to materials. As we already discussed, there is the material picker. When you click on it, you will be able to select the material where you click inside your viewport. If you want to unselect that tool, you can simply click on the right button of your mouse to unselect that one. So here I've selected that wood material on that bench. The way I've created that project is that if I'm changing that color, it's affecting all my bench, as you can see here. It's because all those benches use the same material. If I want to drag and drop a material on my bench, same idea here. When I will drag that material, it will affect all my benches. So let's actually, for example, drag that mahogany wood here. I'm going to drag it on my bench. And as you can see, my three other bench has been affected by that new material. If we do it with a completely different material, like that concrete, we can see it way better. There is an option that will allow you to apply a material only to the specific mesh you are drag and dropping that material onto. This is this option here. By default, it's set on Replace Material, but you can also apply to object. If you turn this option on, you will be able to apply a material only on the selected mesh. This way, now I can customize the bench on the right without impacting the others. Let's talk now about UVs. At the top of the screen, it's the second option related to materials. By default, it uses the From Object UV. That means that we keep the UV that you have defined in your CAD software. But sometimes you didn't set any UVs. And that's the case, for example, with that geometry over on my project. As you can see here, on the top, it looks pretty good, even though there is some weird sketchy line on that side. But on the side, it's even worse. We can see that I didn't set any UV on that mesh and the texture is completely stretched. To fix that, usually the best solution would be to come back in your CAD software and fix them manually there. But in some CAD software, there is no option to set your UVs, and often you don't have the time. So that's why in Twinmotion, there are some quick tools to manually force a UV. So here, if you click on that option, the one I'm using the most is the cubic UVs that will force a cubic projection of the texture on the specific mesh you are using that material on. So for example, here if I click on the cubic UV, and if I'm dragging and dropping a material from the library to that mesh, as you can see here, now my sides are looking pretty good, same as my top. You will see still some stretches on really the edge, like we can see on that small bevel, we can see that the cubic projection is not working perfectly in that case. But if you are not doing some close-up on that part of your project, usually that will fix most of the problem you might have. Let's now create a new material together. To do that, the first thing you will need to do is go towards the bottom of the screen and click on the materials icon. Here, when you click on that icon, it opens that dock that contains all the material used somewhere in your project. You can see which materials are actually affected on a mesh with that small check that you can see on the top left corner. If you want to see that a bit better, you can select the material, and in the property panel, we can also see that check. When you see two checks like that, that means that this specific material is applied on more than one mesh. So for example, here, if I'm coming closer to my bench, let's come back with a wood, scrolling down to the bottom to use that red cedar now. Here that red cedar, I just simply drag and drop it that material on that specific bench, so it has one check. If I'm now drag and dropping the same material a second time, this time I will use the turn ball from the property panel, or I can also use the turn ball from that dock here. If I'm using that, it will apply the same material, and now as you can see, we have those two checks here. When you don't have any check, that just means that this material is not used anymore. You can also replace a material that you have selected by drag and dropping a new material from the library onto the selected material. To do that, I will click on, for example, that mahogany wood, going to drag and drop that material and drop it over my red cedar. That will completely replace my previous material by that new one. At some point, you may want to clean the material that you don't use inside your project. The simplest way to do it will be to click on the first material, use that slider bar to go towards the end of the list, press Shift, click on the last one, and simply click on Delete on your keyboard. That will remove all the unused material that you might have used at some point in your project, but that you don't need anymore. So now let's create a new material. To do that, I will click on the plus button. When you use that plus button, it creates a standard material. But bear in mind that you can use any material from the ToonMotion library, drag and drop it somewhere inside your scene, and use it as a base to customize it and load new textures. For this video, I'm just going to create a new material from scratch. Here, over that small menu, I can click on that and I can rename it. Now let's actually load some texture. I will come to the property panel. I will first click on Color, Details, and I'm going to load my texture. For this video, I'm going to simply create a moss type of material. So I'm going to load that moss texture. Right now, this material is not applied anywhere inside my project. That means if I want to have a better look at what it will look like at the end, my best solution will be to simply drag and drop that material somewhere in my scene. Maybe on my parking like that. So now that we see the material inside the scene, it will be a bit easier to customize it. Now let's load some of the other textures that came with that material. So I can come to the normal map, details, I will load my normal map. I can also load my height map. And finally, my roughness texture. So now that all my texture has been loaded, I can come to the UV and modify the scale of them. Finally, the last touch on that specific material will be maybe to add some grunge, again, to break up the repetition. Now that I have created that material, it's affected on my project. If I would like at some point to reuse that material on a future project, what I can do is click on that menu here and add that material to my user library. As I said, ToonMotion comes with hundreds, if not thousands, of materials. But if I come to my library, at the end we have the user library that allows anyone to save their own material and their own objects. So if I come to my user library here, I will scroll to the bottom and here we have the new material we just created. If I want to keep a good organization, a good habit will be to create a folder dedicated to materials. At the top here, you can click on the plus to create a new folder and I can rename that folder the way I want, for example, materials. And now I can simply drag and drop the asset I want in that folder. So let's, for example, drag and drop some of the material I have in the root folder of my library. Now, if I come to my material folder, I have those two materials ready there. The last feature I want to show in that video is the colored shadow with the glass. First, you will need to come in the materials folder, glass, scroll towards the bottom, and here we will find the tinted glass. When you drag and drop a material and while you are in raster mode like I am right now, you don't see any effect. It's because this effect, the colored shadow, is only available in Path Tracer. That means here I will need to hit the Path Tracer button to see the effect. So as you can see here right now, it's a bit noisy, pass tracer is calculating, but we already have a really good idea of the look of our project with that colored shadow. Here we can drag and drop multiple material to see how it will affect our project. If you want to learn more about the pass tracer, there is a dedicated article about pass tracer requirements on our support website. Just to make it short, we recommend to have 8 GB of VRAM and it needs to support DXR. And of course, you can also manually control that color by simply clicking on the color wheel here and choosing manually the color you want. And that's it for this video on materials. Thank you everyone for watching it and we will see you all for the next one. Bye everyone.